Yeah.
What does that mean?
Your basic, way lower working class, white boy desert town sort of. No culture, no class, no nothing.
Is that good for your music?
All my experience feeds my music, but it's just where I come from.
Pretty much grew up in Southern California, and when enough, you know, every time I picked up a guitar, there was a friend of the family who was a failed, you know, musician, or in their mind failed, not in my mind, because I loved them, but they would take me aside and give me the talk all my life as a child. And then I went to, you know, I lived in Hollywood and I lived in Los Angeles, and you see people, like, the turnover is amazing, people getting signed, dreams being inflated, and just bang, bang, bang. I really admire great artists. I mean, totally admire great artists that have, that you know, were allowed to fail, were allowed to be human, were allowed to make the most glorious dances they could ever imagine, and totally fall and get back up, because it's all human. But if you're made, you know, if you're like this side of, you know, Danny Partridge, it's like, it's totally impossible. I'm not like that. This is like, I grew up with this.
Well, this is our last goodbye. I hate to feel the love between us die, but it's over. Just hear this and then I'll go. You gave me more to live for, more than you'll ever know.
You've gone from low-key, relatively unknown to being one of the most talked about artists in recent times. Are you comfortable with that?
No.
Why not?
Not at all.
Because it's, I don't know. It's just really, it doesn't match.
What you're about?
Not really. I mean, because I'm so aware of the climate of this culture right now, just wanting, you know, say, like, be great heroes to, like, shove up there and see how they do, and then when they go down, it's like, you know, this is not a time for careers, but I got nothing else to do. This is what I do, and I just don't feel comfortable with the, I don't feel that the work has risen up to that level, so I don't know why people are talking about it. I'd really rather the people not even think about me as a face or a name or a body and just come and listen, really.
When most artists would kill to have the attention that you're getting.
Well, that's great. And the music business is really actually made for them. I don't mind being known for something that if I discover cancer or discover the cure for cancer or something, I wouldn't mind, like, being the most famous guy in the world, because it's a beautiful thing, but I just am just still kind of shy about this.
Grace mean to you?
Everything that the word carries. Grace is what matters in anything, especially life, especially growth, tragedy, pain. Love, death. About people, that's what matters. That's a quality I admire very greatly. It keeps you from reaching for the gun too quickly. It keeps you from destroying things too foolishly. It sort of keeps you alive. And it keeps you open for more understanding. It also helps you when, it's also, you know, people say grace for dinner, and God is great, God is good, you know, but I see an invocation when I hear that word. And also, it's like the sound of it, really.
So saying the word grace invokes a state of grace.
It could. The song itself is about, is just,
It's an elegy to no one. About, I always describe it as, you know, not fearing anything, anyone, any man, any woman, any war, any gun, any sling or arrow aimed at your heart by other people, because there is somebody finally who loves you for real, and that you can achieve a real state of grace through somebody else's love in you. You know, when you're totally out of fuel and totally out of understanding. So I said it. It's a song about my death, but not fearing it.
I love you, but I'm afraid to love.
Everybody knows what it's like to create an artistic moment, so-called artistic moment, because it's really just heightened humanism. It's just a heightened human language. If you've spent a night making love, you know exactly what it means to strip your ego down, where you are there expressing yourself wordlessly, collaborating on a moment that has an energy about it that is replenishing or even completely inspirational in a way you could never imagine. And that's the way art really is. Or if you've raised a child, that is an artistic venture, baby. You solve problems. You express yourself to the kid. You feed your soul to the kid, or else he or she doesn't, you know, they get you. And that's art. That's an artistic moment. And everybody has done it. Everybody will do it. It's not just musicians. You don't have to feel left out. It's like, you know what it's like. It just culminates in music for me. And it may culminate in somebody's teaching job for them, or it may culminate in a construction worker or an architect. Or
did you always know that it would be music for you?
I never gave it a second thought.
I know that you're constantly searching in terms of where you want to take your music and where the music, frankly, leads you, but where did you shape your musical vision? Was it what you heard? Was it what you felt pulling out of the air? And how long have you been carrying this vision? Was it clearly defined early on as to how you wanted to make music?
Yes, yes.
And yes?
Maybe. I suppose I would... Maybe, meaning to always having it. I guess I always knew what I didn't want, but I prefer, it's sort of like predicting the future. I mean, like any time you make plans for the future, an emotional future with somebody, or, you know, any future whatsoever, there's nothing quite as spectacular as what the future will provide you without your help. So, oh boy, I hope I pull this into some sense
now. You can do it now, man. Do focus.
What I mean is, when I have an arrangement in mind, or when I have a song, an issue inside, like a song coming out, I don't put a result on it. I don't put it like, I want this to do this, and I want this section to do this, blah, blah, blah. It comes, the emotion has lyrics and a melody and a background to it, and I let it shape itself.
Are you surprised then where the music takes you?
No, because it's somewhere recessed. It's sort of like a storm that you see off in the distance, and you know you will get messed up by the storm, you just sit and wait for it.
Well,
What's your greatest regret?
I don't really have regrets. I don't.